Hello everybody and welcome. My name is Mashmar and I'll be your host this evening. So welcome to this first episode of my Fallout New Vegas Let's Play. Wow, this is gonna be amazing. I've played this game before, so I know what I'm getting myself into. So yeah, I've already started the game. I'm at the menu right now. So we're just gonna go ahead and create a new game here. And yeah, we'll start our adventure. Alright, let's do it. So excited.
Changes. When atomic fire consumed the Earth, those who survived did so in great underground vaults. When they opened, their inhabitants set out across the ruins of the old world to build new societies, establishing villages, forming tribes. As decades passed, what had been the American Southwest united beneath the flag of the new California Republic, dedicated to old world values of democracy and the rule of law. As the Republic grew, so did its needs. Scouts spread east, seeking territory and wealth in the dry and merciless expanse of the Mojave Desert. They returned with tales of a city untouched by the warheads that had scorched the rest of the world, and a great wall spanning the Colorado River. The NCR mobilized its army and sent it east to occupy Hoover Dam and restore it to working condition. But across the Colorado, another society had arisen under a different flag. A vast army of slaves forged from the conquest of 86 tribes, Caesar's Legion. 4 years have passed since the Republic held the dam, just barely, against the Legion's onslaught. The Legion did not retreat. Across the river, it gathers strength. Campfires burn, training drums beat. Through it all, the New Vegas Strip has stayed open for business, under the control of its mysterious overseer, Mr. House, and his army of rehabilitated tribals and police robots. You are a courier, hired by the Mojave Express to deliver a package to the New Vegas Strip. What seemed like a simple delivery job has taken a turn for the worse.
You got what you were after, so pay up.
You're crying in the rain, Pally.
Guess who's waking up over here?
Time to cash out.
Will you get it over with?
Maybe cons kill people without looking them in the face. But I ain't a fink. Dig? You've made your last delivery, kid. Sorry you got twisted up in this scene. From where you're kneeling, must seem like an 18-carat run of bad luck. Truth is, the game was rigged from the start.
I'm so excited. So that was the intro, and now the game actually begins. So let's do this.
You're awake. How about that? Whoa, easy there, easy. You've been out cold a couple of days now. Why don't you just relax a second? Get your bearings. Let's see what the damage is. How about your name? Can you tell me your name?
Oh yeah. My name is Mashmar. Oh yeah.
I can't say it's what I'd have picked for you, but if that's your name, that's your name.
Dick.
I'm Doc Mitchell. Welcome to Good Spring.
More like Dick Mitchell.
Now, I hope you don't mind, but I had to go rooting around there in your noggin to pull all the bits of lead out. I take pride in my needlework, but you'd better tell me if I left anything out of place. How'd I do?
Well, you get the sex, right? So let's do a male for this character, and a Caucasian male. Just for the simplicity of it all. Do we want to look like any of these people? You looking fancy, aren't you? Let's do that. Now, I'm kind of satisfied with that hair. We need some facial hair, though, to make it look sexy. Whoa, too. I'm just gonna go with this. Keep it simple, you know. Yeah, that's us.
I got most of it right anyway. Stuff that mattered. Okay.
Well, aren't you full of yourself?
No sense keeping you in bed anymore. Let's see if we can get you on your feet.
Alright.
Why don't you walk down to the end of the room? Over by that vigor tester machine there.
Over there? Hmm.
Take it slow now. It ain't a race.
A race? No, we need to get there as fast as we can.
Good so
just
far.
Kidding. I think
go
I'm
ahead
dead.
And give the vigor tester a try. We'll learn right quick.
Vitamatic vigor tester. Let's do it. So we need to set our attribute points, huh? Strength. This affects your melee, unarmed, inventory weight, damage, and weapon effect. Effectiveness. Words are hard. So, I guess we could do with one of those, perhaps. Inventory weight is always nice. Damage and stuff. Perception. This affects your explosives, lockpick, energy weapons, accuracy, and compass range. Not super necessary, but would help a lot. I'm gonna skip it for now. Endurance. Unarmed, health, resistance, and survival. No, I don't think we'll be needing that, to be honest. Charisma. Now here's something that we might need. This affects your barter, speech, companion, and nerve. So what barter is, it's like your... your ability to speak to salesmen and and people that wants to buy or sell stuff. This usually means that you can get great discounts on items, and you can also sell your loot and items for a little more money. We also need speech so that we can convince people to do what we want them to do. So I'm gonna bring this up by 2. So we get 7 points in total. That will be nice. And let's move on. Intelligence. This affects your science, repair, medicine, and skill points. This we need. Science is to hack computers and unlock doors and stuff. Repair is to repair all your tools, weapons and stuff. Also to repair robots and stuff, companions, and so on. Medicine increases your health when you're using stim packs, which is like health packs, and yeah. And yeah, skill points, self-explanatory in my opinion. So let's move on. Agility, this affects your guns. Sneak, my speed and action point regeneration. This is also good. I usually use regular guns and not like energy guns or grenades or melee weapons. I play with regular guns. And so this will be beneficial for us. Also, it's always good to have some action point regeneration. So let's move on. Luck. Affects all skills, critical hits, and enemy mishaps. Mishaps, perhaps. I don't know how that's pronounced, actually. But yeah. So let's review. Strength, we got 6. Perception and endurance, we got 5. Charisma, 7. Intelligence, 6. Agility, 6. And luck, 5. That will be awesome. So let's do it.
Yeah, let's keep that. That's a pretty standard score there, but after what you've been through, I'd say that's great news. Well, we know your vitals are good, but that don't mean them bullets didn't leave you nutter than a bighorn or dropping. What do you say you take a seat in my couch and we go through a couple of questions? See if your dogs are still barking.
All right. Can I pick up stuff? Ooh, I can. Woo! Tossing books. Since 2014. Alright, I'm gonna sit down. Ooh, I'm naked.
Alright. I'm gonna say a word. I want you to say the first thing that comes to mind.
Vagina.
Dog.
Oh. Cat.
House.
Renovate, actually? No, investment.
Night.
Yeah. Night, I would have thought of like day or something. I would have gone with dream, but I don't sleep at night. I'm playing video games. Oh yeah. I would have gone with silence, but I guess silencer will have to cover for it.
Bandit.
We want to crush bandits, don't we? Swiss cheese. Yeah, that's the first thing that came to mind. Lol. We're gonna crush
them.
Dark, of course. Mother. Human shield.
Sometimes when you give tests like this, you learn more than you was hoping for, and I reckon that ain't always the best thing. But I guess maybe it explains a thing or two about your predicament.
Oh, really?
Okay. Now, I got a few statements. I want you to tell me how much they sound like something you'd say. First one. Conflict just ain't in my nature.
Wow, that really depends. Do you mean conflict in a good way or a bad way? I don't want to start fights, but I won't... sure as hell want to kill all the people that messes with me or get in my way. I think he means the negative way, like starting fights. I'm gonna disagree on this one.
I ain't given to relying on others for support.
I agree.
I'm always fixing to be the center of attention.
Well, aren't we all? Let's agree to that.
I'm slow to embrace new ideas.
No, we're not. We're quick thinkers and innovators.
I charge in to deal with my problems head on.
Yes, that we do.
Almost done here. What do you say you have a look at this? Tell me what you see.
I see a cloud. So I guess a chemical reaction, you know, like the clouds that comes from the chimneys on the factories. Sort of. So I'm gonna go with the chemical reaction.
Okay. How about this one?
Wow. Yeah, I'm too embarrassed to say what this looks like. Love it.
Last one.
Well, I would say it's two guys, 2.5. Like, this is the head. This is the hands clapping each other, and this is the kneecaps of the two persons. I have no idea. Let's go with a light in the darkness.
Well, that's all she wrote. I don't have nothing to compare it to, so maybe you'd better just have a look at the results.
All
see
right.
If it all seems right to you.
Okay, so you want me to put on unarmed signs and melee weapons. First of all, I don't use unarmed that often, so that won't be helpful at all. So I'm just gonna uncheck that and place it at speech. Like I said before, the speech skill governs how much you can influence someone through dialogue and gain access to information they might otherwise not want to share. Just listen to it and yeah, I'm sure it will be beneficial for us in our playthrough. And like I said, I don't use melee weapons that much. I'm using regular guns. So I'm gonna place this on guns. And the difference between energy weapons, explosives and guns are simply that energy weapons are like futuristic alien weapons, like as you can see on the picture. Explosives are like mines, grenades, missile launchers and Fat Man's best guns. Best gun in the world, the Fat Man. And guns, which I like to use, is like the normal ones. Guns determines your effectiveness with guns determine your effectiveness with any weapon that uses conventional ammunition. So like regular guns, which you would see in normal life. Also, they want me to put 1 point in science, which led me to hack terminals and stuff. But I'm gonna uncheck that, I think. And I want to place it on barter, just because, so we can get lower prices and sell for higher prices, and it also unlocks a few more options when trying to negotiate with salesmen or shopkeepers that might be beneficial for us when we're doing quests and stuff, if we need items and stuff. So this is what I'm gonna go with. The barter, the guns, and the speech. And what this skill does, it's simply placing, 15 points in the selected skill. So yeah, 15 points to barter, guns, and speech. And let's hit done. And move on.
Before I turn you loose, I need one more thing from you. I got a form for you to fill out so I can get a sense of your medical history. Just a formality. Ain't like I expect to find you got a family history of getting shot in the head.
No. Right, let's choose some traits. Build to destroy. All weapons have a 3+ chance to critical hit, but equipment conditions decays. Wow, that's not good. You fire 20% quickly, but your shots are 20% less accurate. That's nothing that we want. You're good natured at heart, more prone to solving problems with your mind than violence. You gain 5+ to barter, medicine, repair, science, and speech, but have a -5 to energy weapons, explosive guns, melee weapons, and arm. I think that would be beneficial for us, actually. Since we will be using a lot of bard skills, medicine, repair, and science skills. And also speech. Forgot that. But since we only will be using, or mainly will be using regular guns, I don't mind having some negative points on energy weapons, explosives, and so on. I need to change the sensitivity of the mouse. It's really fast. I think you have 10 plus action points, but you have, but your reckless nature causes you to have -2 damage threshold. I think that might be beneficial as well, since it's always good to have action points. And like, -2 damage threshold, that's not really something that we need to be concerned about. Since we when we get more action points, we can hit the enemies a lot more times. So if that decreases our damage a little bit, I think it will even itself out with extra action points, if that makes sense. So yeah, I'm gonna hit done and we're gonna move on.
All right, I guess that about does it. Come with me, I'll see you out.
Alright. Oh, wow, throwing books. Before we go and see him, I think we should have a look around, see if we got some useful things we can grab. What's that? Oh, medics. That's good, good, good. Ophthalmoscope. I have no idea how you pronounce that. Oh, gun case. Sweet, a laser pistol and some ammunition to it. We got steam packs. For those of you that doesn't know, steam packs are like health packs. I think I mentioned that, but just to clarify, so we want a lot of steam packs so that we can heal ourselves when we go into battle. Ammunition box. Sweet, some ammo. First aid box. And we're gonna grab the dirty water just because. Ooh, bobby pin. Oh, sweet, doctor bag, which restores all body parts, even if we are crippled. And yeah. Ooh, speech plus 5. I'm gonna take that. Yeah, it was an outfit or Abraxo cleaner. Abraxo. Refrigerator, banana, yuki fruit, beer, crispy squirrel, dirt war. I'm gonna take it all. Pile of don't really need that at the moment. Gonna need it later though if we want to do some repairing and upgrading and stuff. A hat. And ooh, some bottle caps. Oh, for those of you who don't know, there is no currency in this game where you have like money. Instead, the currency that we're using is bottle caps from like drinks. Ooh, Sunset Sarsaparilla. For example, here we have a soda, and if we drink this, we regenerate some HP, but we will also get the cap of that bottle, which we can then use to purchase stuff and so on. So yeah, let's go talk to Mitchell here.
These are yours. Was all you had on you when you brought in.
Oh, 15 packs, 18 bottle caps.
Mind, but I gave the note a look. Ooh, I thought it might help me find a next of kin.
Oh, sweet, we got
but
a pistol.
It was just something about a platinum chip. Well, if you're heading back out
and
there, you ought to have this.
3,000.
They call it a pip boy. I grew up in one of them vaults they made before the war. We all got one. Ain't much use to me now, but you might want such a thing after what you've been through. I know what it's like having something taken from you. And put this on, too, so the locals don't pick on you for lacking modesty. Never was much my style, anyway.
Thanks for patching me up, Doc.
Don't mention it. It's what I'm here for. You should talk to Sunny Smiles before you leave town. She can help you learn to fend for yourself in the desert. She'll likely be at the saloon. I reckon some of the other folks at the saloon might be able to help you out, too. And the metal fella, Victor, who pulled you out of your grave. Anyway, you ever get hurt out there, you come right back. I'll fix you up.
Cheers,
try
man.
Not to get killed anymore.
Hardcore mode. Follow new versus to play in new hardcore mode. No, we don't. We do not want to play in hardcore mode. Guess where it was. Quest complete. Ain't that a kick in the head? Sweet. So yeah, let's take a look in our Pip-Boy. For those of you that don't know what the Pip-Boy is, it's like... it's a smartwatch. No, but sort of. You can check your status, the health of all your body parts, you can check your skills, perks, and so on. You can also check your data, you can go into the radio, check all your quests, check the maps, and so on. You can also check in our items, our clothes. Here we got our weapons. Oh, I'm gonna equip this pistol. And here's our clothes. Melee weapon +2 and speech +2. I'm gonna equip this hat. Get 1 plus perception. Speech +5. Do we want that instead of the meat? I think we want this instead. I think the speech +5 is better than the... I don't really need the melee weapon plus there. And also we can check our... aid. Here's our all of our food and health packs or steam packs and such. Also our misks, pub pins, ammunition, and here's our ammunition. So yes, yeah, I think that'll be all for this episode. Let's take a whoa, looking fancy. That is B.A. looking like a boss. So yeah, I think that'll be everything for this episode. If you like this episode, be sure to subscribe and follow this series. We will be doing a lot of cool things in the series, I hope. So yeah. In the next episode, we will be doing the quest we just received. And we'll go and talk to Sunny Smiles in the Prospector Saloon. Out in Good Spring, leaving through the stores. So, yeah, thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next episode. My name is Mashmall, and I've been your host this evening. Have a good one. Peace out.